Welcome to Interface. Today we have with us an eminent scholar, writer, poet, and a microbiologist with us as our guest. Ma'am Mariam Al Shenasi, we would like to know your career as a microbiologist.
Well, when I decided to study biology, my focus was on microbiology, and then I enrolled in Faculty of Science, and I've been accepted in biology department, and then I carry on with it, focusing on microbiology because I do believe that I need to learn a lot about the microorganism, what is happening in that small environment, and what the interaction between different kind of microorganisms. After that, I carried on with my PhD, and I left my country to go for about five years to Scotland to study microbiology and focusing on the aflatoxin and the carcinogenic things. It's produced from different kind of fungus. It is naturally a carcinogenic chemical. And my thesis was focusing also on very specific fruits, date fruits, which is available and valuable fruits in my country. And we would like to check if there is a possibility for this aflatoxin to produce in date fruits under the natural environment, or it depends to the normal conditions. So that was my PhD for about 4 years when I was studying in Glasgow Caledonia University.
Yeah, being a microbiologist, you contributed a lot to your country. At the same time, you turned into a publisher. But that's a very rare case, a woman, especially from the Arab traditional family, to become a publisher is a very laborious task. But you are very well established publisher there. What is your opinion about this field? Is it a very, very simple one or a very difficult one?
To shift to be a publisher and for publishing area, it didn't come suddenly, it came gradually. Because I think what we got in my country with a very good education, established education, especially in my generation, it was, I think we were the first generation who got different education, and we got a systematic education compared to the past where it is very simple to be learn few things like learning Arabic, the basic thing, learning Quran and some mathematics and all that thing. But after 1971, when we established the country and we got establishing also the education, we have the base for the education. So it's encouraging us to improve our skills in different areas. One of the skills should be improved in writing. So I liked writing. So it was just coming gradually. But my focus was in science. Why in particular science? Because I do believe that it is in science, I need to learn it I need to learn laboratory, I need to study it, I need somebody to help me to discover all those things. But with publishing and writing, it is just skills. So here where I need to improve my skills. So once I graduate from the PhD, and then I published several books, several papers, and I contributed to many conferences. I published a read paper. So it's about like 48 publishers was published in my subject. And after that, I worked in the university as well for 5 years, University of Sharjah. And then I moved to Ministry of Environment and Water. So it's linked all with my career. But still, I felt like I've got skills where it need to be improved. So then I just moved. So it came gradually.
Yeah. This was quite natural growth.
Yeah, I think so. I do believe in that.
Yeah, that's all right. As a publisher and as a woman, what is the obstacles you faced?
Well, this is a question quite normal now in my life. I mean, if I faced any barriers, if there is any something happened or something, but I felt like it is my decision, where it cannot be stopped by anyone. If I've got skills and I do believe in it, so I need to improve it, and I need to spend some time to improve these skills. And once I publish in Arabic, in my language, because in science, I need to publish most of the time in English, and it's all refereed papers in international journals, and sometimes in international conferences, based only on scientific solid base or scientific information. And it is laboratory work, which it should be transferred to paper, this journal paper or scientific paper. And writing, it is my skills, my experiences, and how I contribute this also with large people. I mean, it's not limited like scientific, it's only with scientists, but with writing novels, books in different areas, I can contribute this with different people. I mean, not only with specific or specialist people. So here it is guide me that it is, I need to know the world. I mean, I need to know whole people. I need to know more experiences. And this is what attracted me to India, because my father linked with India because he is a businessman and he came to India, especially in Bombay. And this is more than 40 or 50 years. And he feel like India, it's part of his life. And we learned this from him, and he explained a lot about the people who he met and what he learned. And when even we received a guest from India, so they are very welcome to my house. So this is how we contribute with a great country like India. It's a rich country in different areas. So this is, I felt like it is no barriers, or it is, I feel like my life is still, I feel it like it's a basic. Some people, they feel it is amazing in part of it, but I feel it like it's worth to be contributed with other. This is also how I look to it.
Whenever you are trying to make a contribution, as did in the past, as you know, the many Arabs contributed a lot to translate the Indian works like Siddhanta and other things. Mm-hmm. In such case, you are filling the gap between the past and present. Actually, past there was a great tradition of translation, just like the Baitul Hikmah. Mm-hmm. After that, that continuum was stopped. But now, due to your Yasmin publication and others, Kalima publication, it has been restarted, revamped. Is there any plan to continue this one?
The people, how they like reading, education, they do believe in it, they respect the educated people. So that all encouraged me to come. And it was, I think it is in my storybooks or novel, it's a great thing that to translate directly from Arabic to Malayalam. We don't need some other language, international language.
The direct translation. Direct from Arabic to Malayalam, or Arabic to Hindi, or Hindi to Arabic.
Yes. So
there is no need of English as a link language.
English or other language as well. So this is one of improving, I think, and it is a good step to start and to continue with it. And I think all of us, we do believe when the whole world contribute together, working together, we can exchange and learn. It depends what I need from this philosophy, Indian culture, it is rich civilization, and it has part of it, it is really very bright. And also in my culture, we need to exchange from each other. I mean, traveling, it is really great thing when we travel abroad and see people, different culture, different mentality, different way of thinking. And then when they read our storybooks, it is our life also, our experiences. And when I talk about only novel and some cultural books, but also we need to look to the science, philosophy, and other things. Darul Yasmin doing maybe a small part now. It's playing really very small part. I mean, to encourage that it is we need to learn different languages. We need to learn about others. We need to learn from their experiences. And we, how we can contribute in all those and play a role in all that and improve our life, the standard of living. I think not only in health, but also in social. Not only on social, but also in economy. So it is different thing. Translation, no doubt that it is, we need this. And we need to work a lot about it. Yeah.
Yeah, you are president of UAE Publishers, and normally it is an area dominated by, mastered by the male. But at the same time, now a woman is in the position of a president. How do you feel that?
I think in my country it is completely different because women now dominate in this.
Yeah.
So before it was Sheikha Bedour.
Yeah.
She was the first woman to be president in Emirates, and now she is playing a part in internationally.
Yeah.
And then I came, but I felt that it is because it is just 2 months since I've been appointed to be in this position. It was by election. It is something great to help everyone, especially the writers.
Yeah.
And writers all the time complain from publishers, and publishers thinking that they are victim of writers. So this relationship still is not balanced still.
Yeah.
Yeah, it is not balanced. And in my country also, we now trying to modify the vision of the publishing, what we need, what is the vision, what we need to do and how it should. And it is modified in one sentence, maybe two words, that we need to improve should be industrial of publishing, because we need to respect the writer and the publisher in the same time, and it's the same, they are equal. We cannot sacrifice one of them. We need both of them.
To balance them.
Yes. And to also balance the relationship between writers.
Both publishers and
writers. But I feel like I'm more with the side of publishers because I need to defend also their rights. Most of the time we're talking about the rights of the writers.
Yeah.
And then we need also to talk about the rights of publishers. Yes. Yeah, so a publisher put a lot of money, a lot of effort, they do the distribution, they travel, they try to announce, they do try to advertise, they also play a role in it. So they are equal and it should be balanced. If we want this to be moved to industrial, we say we have an Arab world or a country like United Arab Emirates, we need to work on it. So this will be balance between writers and publishers as well.
Yeah, it is known that you are a part and parcel of a Sadhana Cultural Foundation. You would like to know something about the Sadhana Cultural Foundation and its activities.
Yeah, Sadhana, it's because they heard about the Arabic festival, which I try to contribute with Calicut University. It is a historic university, and they rooted back to maybe years in Arabic culture, and the Department of Arabic, it's also really, it's improved, and they put effort to give the best education for the student. So by having and hosting this festival, people learn a lot from the novel, from the writing, from the what is going on, I mean, in writing, especially in Arabic countries. And they heard about this, they would like to participate and contribute in it. So we say this is your chance to also put a light on what you are doing in Sadhana. As the owner, Sheikha Asma bin Sagr al-Qasimi, Her Highness, she's supporting many writers. She's supporting any kind of cultural thing, cultural activities. And she was really happy to hear that it is in India. There are many people, they learn this about the Arabic art and poet, novel. They would like to read more. And also they like to read updated books.
Yeah, to propagate Arab culture and heritage.
Yes, yeah.
It is well known fact that the Sharjah is the cultural capital of UAE.
Mm-hmm.
And what is the role played by the Sharjah to to disseminate the knowledge, to disseminate the, to transparent the culture of the Arab nations?
Mm-hmm. I think I have to admit that it is all what we achieved in Sharjah city. It's belonging to His Highness Sheikh Sultan bin Hamad Al Qasimi, the ruler of the Sharjah. And he put the pillars about cultural. And he put the pillars and seeds about what is culture, what is the book fair, the meaning of that thing. And he put many prizes. And he support the society by even giving us the his experience in that. And by, I think this now we worked in this 40 years, and he did a lot, not only in publication and books and writing, also in theater, cinema, and translation. His book translated to many different languages, Indian languages, I'm talking in India. It is all true stories coming from the history, but it is maybe unknown history or part of the history. It is small stories happened in the past, and he is highlighting on those stories. So from him we learn a lot, especially in a school. They take us in different activities, and then gradually we learn and how the important about culture and what is the meaning of reading. And how this reading is enlightening our life. It is make a path for us, reading. Whether I agree with you in the concept or I disagree, but at the end of the day, we have different way of living. We have different way of things to do and to contribute or to discuss. For that, I think the main thing in Sharjah that it is should be admitted to His Highness Sheikh Sultan bin Muhammad Al Qasimi.
Thank you, ma'am. Dr. Mariam Shenasi.